Hi guys, thank you all for tuning in and welcome back to Sewing Clara. Today we're going to be discussing sewing machine needles. Now these are all the sewing machine needles that I have currently at home, and you will notice that there is always a set of numbers with letters and then more numbers on the bottom on each packaging, and that might sound a little confusing at the beginning, but don't worry, with the help of this video you will understand what it all means and you will be able to pick the correct sewing machine needle for your sewing project. So let's jump right into this. So first, let's have a look at what type of needles I actually have here. So I have here universal needles, then I have here two packages of needles for stretchy materials, one additional package for very fine stretchy materials like microfiber. Then I have here some leftover needles from old projects. We'll go into that later. And I also like keeping at home enough denim needles and leather needles. And this is a needle I haven't used yet, to be honest. It's a double needle for stretchy materials. And these are needles that simply spilled. And I need to use a magnifying glass to read the description what they are for, but that's again something I'll explain later. Let's start first with what a needle actually looks like. I have here a universal sewing machine needle, which is going to help us with the explanation, but I also made a sketch because I find it easier to understand. So when you grab one of your sewing machine needles, you will notice that they have this wider section on one side that is slightly rounded on the top, and then it gets narrower and it leads to the point of the needle where the needle eye is. So there are sewing machine needles with the label 130/705, and that's sewing machine needles where the shank, which is also the widest part here on the top, is flat from one side. There are also sewing machine needles where the shank is round, and that would be the label 287WH. But that's not the case here. All the needles that you have seen that I have at home are 130/705. And there is usually a letter that accompanies this label. We'll go into that later, but this is just the basic knowledge you need to know. So when I grab one of my boxes, or let's just grab two different boxes, you will see that it says on both 130/705. Again, that means that the shank is flat on one side. So we can check this because we went through the first important point. Now let's go again over each section of the sewing machine needle. So we already covered the shank, which is flat when you look at the needle from the side. The way you put your sewing machine needle into your sewing machine is that the rounded side is facing towards you while the flat side is facing away from you. The shank gets a little bit narrower at some point, and that's called the shoulder. That's also the place on your sewing machine needle where you might find some color coding. That will help you distinguish your sewing machine needles, if that's the case, if you have them spilled like I have. Now, what do these stripes mean? So the top stripe tells you what type of a sewing machine needle you have in your hand. So orange, for example, means it's for jersey. Then blue means it's for denim. Then we have another stripe that's on the bottom of the sewing machine needle shoulder, and that would tell you the size. So this is, for example, size 70, while blue goes for size, or stands for size 90. I created a file for you guys that you can download, and that's a file with all the color coding, with the needle points, and with the sizing. So don't worry if you don't remember everything that I'm gonna tell you in this video. So we covered the shank, the butt, and the color coding. Next, we have the sewing machine needle shaft. That's the long, lean section. And there is a kind of a dent on the front of your sewing machine needle, which is called the groove. So when you hold the sewing machine needle so that the flat side of the shank is on the bottom and the round side is facing up, when you go with your index finger over the front of the shaft, you will feel that there is a little dent. And that's where the thread gets secured as it leads through the sewing machine needle eye. And then we have the point. So we can check these as well. And the last thing that I want to talk about is the so-called scarf. So when you grab your sewing machine needle and turn it to the side so that you would have on your left side the rounded side of the shank and the flat side would be facing towards your right, when you go with your index finger over the back of the shank, you will notice quite far on the bottom a dent, and that's the scarf. This dent is the section that allows the thread to be grabbed by the bobbing hook. So that kind of connects the top and the bottom thread. Very simply said. So now we can check this too, and we can have a look at more info about sewing machine needles. Now let's talk also about the letters that can stand next to the basic labeling of your sewing machine needles. So we can have an H, which stands for standard. Here we have M, that stands for very fine jersey materials, such as microfiber. We have here double L, can be also labeled as LR, that's for leather. S stands for stretch. There's also labeling SUK. That is for all-purpose embroidery or for heavier stretchy material, for heavier jersey. You could also find the letter Q. That's for quilting. You would also find the letter E. That would be for embroidery. J stands for jeans. And metafil would be for metallic type of thread for embroidery, and that needles would have also a little bit longer eye. You don't have to remember all of this. That's also written in the file that you can download. And you will notice here on the boxes that I have here that some of these don't even have any letters. They simply have the type written on the box, which makes it much easier. And this is even the same brand. So very often you don't have to worry about these letters. It will tell you anyway for what type of material the needles are going to be. And now let's talk about all these numbers on the bottom. So these numbers refer to the size of the sewing machine needle. And they can be either very large numbers. These are the numbers that are being used wherever is used the metric system. They refer to the fraction of a millimeter. So when it says that the size of a needle is 60, it means the needle is 0.6 millimeters thick. And the bottom row is for the US sizing. Now some packages have it very convenient because they list both systems. This one has only the European system, but don't worry, everything is listed in the file that you can download. The smaller the number, the thinner the needle is going to be, and vice versa. So for fine materials such as chiffon or microfiber, you would use something between 60 and 70. A sewing machine needle that has a size between 70 and 80 would be great for cotton fabrics or spandex. Anything around 90 would be great for denim or thicker jersey, fleece. Size 100 would be suitable for rather heavy denim, and anything beyond that would be more for thick leather or upholstery. So that would be like sizes 110 and 120. I don't even have these needles because I don't need them. I don't work with that thick materials. Even though sewing machine needles are such small things, they are a very important part of the whole sewing puzzle. They have to be in an impeccable shape. Otherwise, they could cause some trouble with your sewing machine and they could mess up your stitches. So one thing that usually happens over time is the point usually gets a little blunt, which is normal because the sewing machine keeps hitting the fabric over and over, and at some point it will lose some of its sharpness, and in that case you will have to replace the needle. Also, sometimes you can be sewing with pins inside of the fabric and the needle might accidentally hit a pin, and that can cause some damage on your sewing machine needle. It can get bent or the point might get damaged, and that would then cause trouble with your stitches. And there is a very easy way how to find out whether your needle has been damaged or not. So for that you will need a piece of an old pantyhose, and you simply pull it over one of your hands, and then you will grab your sewing machine needle and you will go with the tip over the surface of your pantyhose. And if it slides without any trouble, then your sewing machine needle should be still okay. I can also try to like poke it through, and if I notice that nothing gets caught, you can still use the needle. However, if something like this happens, where you can see it clearly gets caught, that's a needle that needs to be thrown away and replaced, because there is something wrong with the point, probably bent or maybe damaged after hitting a pin, so this one needs to go. Another thing you have to keep in mind is the size of the eye of a sewing machine needle. There are limits when it comes to the thickness of a thread that you can be using with your needles. It always depends on how big the eye is. So I have here this standard polyester thread that I like using for most of my projects, and I pulled it through one of the universal needles, and when I grab the piece of thread and hold it at about 45 degrees angles, you will notice that the needle keeps sliding nicely back and forth, which also means that the eye is big enough for this thread, and this thread is safe to use for my sewing projects with this needle. Now I have here another thread, that's a denim thread. I like using this one especially for embroideries, but I pulled it through this needle, that's a denim needle, but look what happens when I hold it at 45 degrees. The needle simply gets stuck and doesn't move, which tells me that for this sewing needle, this thread would be too thick. I would have so much trouble, the stitches wouldn't be right, the thread might tear, and it would just not be working. I have here a needle with a little bit larger eye. I pulled the same thread through, and now when I hold it, it starts sliding, but it doesn't still slide perfectly. So I might want to look into sewing machine needles with even a little bit larger eyes if I would want to use this type of thread. So this is very important to keep in mind. And one last tip when it comes to sewing machine needles, if you, for whatever reason, lose the packaging of your sewing machine needles and you no longer know what size they are, there is a very simple trick how to find it out. So you will grab your sewing machine needle and you will make sure that you hold it with the flat side to the bottom. And here on the side, on the rounded side of the shank, you will find very tiny writings, and they will tell you what size the needle is. So either you have a magnifying glass, which will make it super easy and you can very quickly determine what size your sewing machine needle is, or if you don't have a magnifying glass, you can grab your phone, you open the camera and you simply zoom in as far as you can, and then you should be able to read the size. And that is going to be it for this video. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it helpful. Don't forget to check out the file called Sewing Machine Needles, and that's where you will find the overview when it comes to sizing and types of needles and the color coding. So thank you all for watching and happy sewing.